Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout is an A-class contest at 59 kilograms. Please welcome first up to ringside, Callum McGowan. Opening contest, his debut, but since then four wins out of five for young Callum McGowan. Makes his way into the ring for this 59 kilo A-class contest.
And his opponent, please welcome to ringside, Isaac Taylor.
He's the underdog in this contest because of the man now making his way to the ring. Don't look at that fight record on your screen. Can't actually correct. He's 9 wins from 9 contests during his career so far. We'll aim to take this into double figures tonight. This is his inaugural A-class contest though. So a step up for him, only 17 years of age, but as we've seen already tonight, Kieran, the youngsters have really been out in force this evening and put on a terrific show. So it's been a real transitional evening for many fighters and could well be for this young man as well.
Tackle Muay Thai League at the Victoria Warehouse in Manchester, England. We are set for an A-class contest at 59 kilograms. This bout will be fought over 5 3-minute rounds. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man stands 5 feet 10 inches tall and weighed in officially at 58.8 kilograms. With 5 fights, 4 of which he was victorious, he is Callum McGowan. And his opponent standing across the ring in the red corner. He stands 5 feet 9 1/2 inches tall. He weighed in officially at 59.2 kilograms. With 9 fights to his belt and 9 victories, he is Isaac Taylor. When the action begins, your referee in charge, Ricky Sewell.
How you doing? You good?
Good.
How's things?
Yeah.
All
right.
So referee Ricky Sewell about to get proceedings underway. A-class 59 kilo contest. Isaac Taylor versus Callum McGowan.
Isaac Taylor in his 17, one of the another teen starlets to come through. Very chiseled, these two, aren't they? They're similar stature. balance there from both of them. Good.
Body kick there from McGowan landed.
Yeah, he would have felt that, that's for sure, even though he did catch it. You see the ripple going through his body.
Good head movement from McGowan. Just get out of trouble there. Now he catches. Well, I haven't seen that before, Kieran.
I've never seen that before either. He got swept and he caught him and brought him down with him.
If I may say, yeah, a little bit unsatisfying. Just when you're expecting the dump. Down again, going upstairs, looking for that high kick. Miller lands low.
They mean business, don't they? Mean business.
Tit for tat in this opening minute and a half.
They've got some good, strong fighters now from Scotland, Grip House. Really trying to suss each other out, but when they kick, the venom and the literally ferocity in the kicks is so hard.
Gowan, right hand to the body, comes in with a kick to the midsection behind it. That high kick just off the gloves and leaning back. 20 seconds to go in round number one, and it's pretty enthralling stuff.
Yeah, both lads are very, very skillful.
McGowan raising his hands aloft, looking over to the crowd triumphantly. A little bit of markings up on the inside of his right leg, the outside of his left. And Taylor too, looking in good condition so far. Not too marked up, a little bit around the midsection from a couple of those teeps. He looks calm and in control so far too.
Feeling, Chris, that this is going to open up, especially as I think it's going to open up quite early as well, round two. You know, both throwing sharp kicks, they're just looking for little openings and gaps. I'm impressed by both of their sort of posture. Whole of tonight, the fighters have all been calm, haven't they? Really calm, you know, courage under fire, but it's at such a young age, that's the impressive thing.
Certainly a showcase and a glimpse of what will have to come in the future, and so much to come this evening as well. And Dakota Dacheva will be returning pretty shortly, in fact, after a short hiatus through injury.
Nice.
That was lovely. Patient in defence, waiting for those kicks.
See McGowan, you know, going left and right, trying to angle for kicks.
Into the clinch they go. McGowan driving those knees up just above hip height. Another one there. Taylor responds, trying to wrestle his man, turning back to the ropes. physical stuff, this energy sapping work too. How much does it take a toll on the forearms and the shoulders when you're blocking those kicks on a consistent basis? What does that do to your offense as well?
Well, I mean, in the gym when you're practicing, obviously you wear the shin pads or you do very, very touch sparring, as they call it, and you can still feel them on your arms, but you sort of become numb to it as such. But in here, when you take a couple of very heavy kicks and you don't catch it or you don't block, you really start to feel it in the later rounds, especially those people who've got those sharp shins as well. Can really, really, if you're a puncher as well, you can really take away your punching completely. And obviously, then your hands drop, and then the idea is obviously a head kick will come over the top.
Sometimes the thinner, bonier shins actually better for inflicting damage rather than the guys with so thicker calves and a bit more muscle on it.
Of course, yeah.
Wow. Reddening on the nose and the left side of the face of Taylor. Those shots got through the middle. That was nice, stiff low kick. Miguel caught and went for the elbow through the middle. Just starting to heat up this one. 30 seconds to go here in round number two.
Yeah, it's starting to be a little bit more assertive now. And see there in the clinch. 17 years old, he's very strong. Kick. They're not fooled at all, are they? Not fooled at all. One little move out of the way, there's a counter for it.
So again, McGowan posturing at the end of that round. We'll be ahead on the judges' scorecards at this stage. Taylor in the corner there, just taking on some water. Again, calm demeanor. Quite go your lad's way, Kieran, in the fight before.
No.
What do you think? How do you kind of analyse that fight? How will you break down that later on?
Well, we knew that Jacob would be strong. We knew that he had heavy low kicks, so we had to prepare for conditions of the legs. The actual plan was to try and nullify that and try and block as many low kicks as possible. Unfortunately, Kieran was getting caught with low kicks. It was a lot to do with he was very nervous before we come out. Unlike him, to be honest with you, usually, even though he looked pretty calm, he was really nervous. So, first couple of rounds, I personally expected Jacob to win, and then Kieran then basically starts to heat up. But he got caught with a nice body shot. I can't take anything away from Jacob. He got caught with a nice body shot, and it basically took all the wind out of Kieran's sails. And as you probably saw, I started thinking other things than Kieran. You know, he starts to think, oh, hold on, I'm losing this, and then we have to try and G him up as much as possible. And we got him to come out for round four, literally try as hard as possible to go for it, but it wasn't meant to be. You know, it was Jacob's night and a good strong puncher.
There you go, you live and you learn, and not always the easiest arena for learning this, often the hardest lessons learned in Muay Thai.
One of those things, you go back to the drawing board, you've got things to pick up on.
So round three here, seeing Isaac Taylor in the red corner, Callum McGowan in the blue. McGowan stalking his man into the corner, just missing with that elbow. Now into the clinch. Oh. Taylor didn't miss that time with the elbow though.
For elbows.
Here we go. Been waiting for it to properly catch fire for some time now, and it was just a little spark between these two there.
Nice slip.
This one has descended into an all-out fight now. Into the clinch they go, McGowan driving in the legs. The marked torsos of both men now apparent. So McGowan just switches stances, looking for an opening. Taylor waiting. Patiently misses by away with the high kick, so does McGowan. Oh,
low kick gets driven in, was it?
Not too sure if that was below the belt or that was a body kick.
Body kick. Well, Taylor shakes his head. Not sure whether he has an indicator to Ricky Saul, the referee, that it was low.
Didn't seem too hurt by it, but
oof, didn't miss by much for that counter, right? Did he?
No, absolutely.
You're right, Kieran. Normally the body shots are the ones you don't recover from, but he seems to be reasonably clear-headed.
I think it was temporary. But still, it gives a big, big edge for the Scotsman. Good elbow there through the middle. Oh, that's a knee. It's a strong knee as well. He might not have shown it, but I think he was softened up by the body kick earlier on. Well, you can see there, look.
We said just now that body shot didn't seem to impact him visually, but just moments later, the story was entirely different, and maybe he hadn't fully recovered as we thought, and as you say, softened up initially, and then the final blow was driven home by Callum McGowan. A really enthralling contest, and good spell shown by both men there. What a good finish it was from the Scotsman.
It was a good finish. You know, when he landed that body kick, he just waited his time, bowed his time, got into the clinch and just started ploughing in knees, hard ones, and put the young man down. It was a shame, actually, for him, because he was doing very, very well. He showed maturity there, but unfortunately, wasn't meant to be.
So while McGowan celebrates, we will await the inevitable official announcement. As we approach the business end of proceedings here at Victoria Warehouse in Manchester, the inaugural Tanco Muay Thai League. As we say, if you've enjoyed the action, you can get in touch with us on Twitter, hashtag TML2017. We'd love to hear from you.
He's got a bright future ahead of him, and I can see him in some very big fights coming up.